Hey everybody, welcome back to The Witcher 3. We are in Oxenfurt, and there's a few people that we want to talk to here. Number one, we're actually going to collect a reward from the girl who asked us to go and look at the Fistech situation. And apparently she's in here. Adela. That's the one.
Avenged your friend.
I knew you'd succeed, puss peepers. I knew it. Go on, out with it. Who was the bastard?
Do I really have to throw him under the bus? Why not?
Bastards. Brethren of the Order of the Flaming Rose.
What'd you do to them? Scald them with hot irons, pick out their eyes, skin them alive.
It's not really my style.
No, just killed them.
Oh, so handsome and so boring. Here, puss peeps, your gold. Ought to be enough for an ounce of panache.
I'm hoping it's about 15,000, based on how expensive the rune rite is. I'm gonna guess no, though. Not even close. But you know what? We do have a relic collection that is just literally collecting dust. And there might be an opportunity to put it towards our runes if we really wanted to. We'll see. Let's go talk to Shani now. This is where things are gonna get interesting. So we have to appease, like, we have to be the proxy to fulfill these three wishes. Olgierd von Everick, he wants us to perform a few tasks for him, and one of these is to show his brother Vladimir the time of his life, but Vladimir's dead. So that brings us to Shani to see if she can direct us to where he might be, and then we're gonna have to figure out a way to at least temporarily resurrect him. The things that we're being asked to do are seemingly impossible, but there must be ways to do it, so. Okay, everybody in here is not in a good situation.
I believe I'll be able to brew an antidote.
Good. A pox in an army can prove more ravaging than even their fiercest foe. Your service will be recognized.
How? Will I get a toad-shaped medal?
The army's not got any medal like that.
Geralt? Are you alright? What's that on your face?
It's a long story.
Long story.
We're conducting important business. Yous can catch up later.
Yes. Right. I'll get to work on the antidote. Shouldn't take long.
Tasty number, that medic. Not like a scholar at all.
Watch it.
Interesting. Curious to know, what do scholars look like to your mind?
Well, all that reading's hard on the eyes, right? So they wear spectacles.
What's wrong with that?
Oh, aye. Thick ones, propped on wrinkled noses, and their clothing, frumpy at best.
Who've they got to dress up for? The books?
Fascinating, really. But if I were you, I'd make sure no medic ever overhears you.
Huh? Why's that?
Because when you get cut in a battle, she might just refuse to stitch you back up.
You're a lucky bastard, witcher. We've seen her making eyes at you. Not like she looks at us. Ain't that right? Admit it. You fancy her too, eh?
I'm not gonna lie. So...
It'd take a blind man to shrug and turn away.
Too true. Meantime, you witches have got especially sharp senses.
Here's the medicine. It's a strong solution, so careful with the dosage. Each patient gets exactly 2 drops after meals, 3 times a day. At the most, in 3-4 days, the infection should recede.
I thank you. In Redania's glorious name.
Serving the Redanian cause now?
I serve individuals. I treat them. That they're Redanians is coincidental. I'd help Nilfgaardians as well, were I in a position to. Kedwenis, Edurnian, elves, dwarves, halflings, the same. Come on, Geralt. You know me.
Yeah, I do. What have you been up to? It's been forever.
Aside from the incident in the sewers, we last saw each other. Must have been in Vizima.
Yes. Yes. When it was ravaged by the Catriona.
Feels like a century ago. Where have you been? What have you been doing since?
Well, I left Vizima and returned to Oxenfurt. Proceeded to finish my doctorate, and then opened a practice. Shortly thereafter, war broke out, and I was press-ganged into the Redanian Medical Corps.
So what now? Radovid's dead.
But the war's not over yet. The chaos continues. I'm still very much needed. Though, I can't complain. At least I live at home now, and I treat the ill, as is my calling.
Fair enough.
Though I must always be ready, for at any time the Redanians might knock with some painfully urgent assignment.
I know that you're busy, and I know that this is what's important to you, but I really need your help.
Shani, I need your help this time.
I'd guess this wasn't a social call. All right, tell me what you need. Is it at all related to that mark on your face? And you must tell me what happened in the sewers.
Let's tell her.
Where do I start? All right. Monster in the sewers turned out to be a giant toad, and this toad was actually a prince, and Ophiri wanted that.
And I'm a Kaviri duchess.
It's the truth. Uncolored, I swear. When I killed the toad, some Ophiri soldiers led by a mage showed up, captured me. A man named Gontaro Dim freed me.
Who's this?
Honestly, he's not a merchant of mirrors.
Could be a mage, a demon, or a djinn.
You don't know?
He's very powerful. That's all I need to know. He helped me out of a bind. Now he expects me to fulfill some nobleman's wishes in return. First one's to summon the ghost of his brother and show him the time of his life.
Amuse a ghost? How do you intend to do that?
Not my chief concern at the moment. Gotta find his grave and summon him first, then we'll see.
But that's necromancy. It's extraordinarily risky and involves higher magic.
Odin told me how to do it. No sorcerers or necromancy involved. Gave me this. Concoction that summons ghosts. I'll need a censer, too.
Well, that can be arranged. They keep one in a storehouse at the academy. I can fetch it for you.
Thanks.
Don't mention it.
She's...
But I still don't...
Honestly, striking.
Neither do I, but I don't really have any options. Gotta summon that ghost.
I understand. Whose ghost is it?
Olgierd von Everek's brother.
Von Everek? In my third year at Oxenfurt, we had to choose an elective. My options were Pearls of Wisdom from the Hierarchs, or famous Redanian dynasties.
Let me guess.
I chose the latter.
Yeah.
Here it is. Von Igrid, von Estiken, von Everek. It says Olgierd had a brother named Vladimir.
That's the one.
He lies in the family crypt near their manor.
Thanks. Knew I could count on you. I'm off.
The crypt's described as quite a work of art. I'd love to see it. Why don't I bring the censer? We can meet at the entrance.
Good idea. I was hoping she'd come along, actually. This is good. Now, what do we got here? Wedding invitation? Being a little bit snoopy, I know, but... Can we sort... Oh. There we go. Let it be known that their children, having grown to share the most profound and noble of sentiments and having decided to seal that bond in hallowed rites, in keeping with ancient custom, the parents of Aldona Lamch and Yannis de Bogar do hereby request the presence of Shani, surname illegible, along with an escort of her choosing at the betrothed's matrimonial ceremony and the celebratory feast to follow. Oh, we are definitely going to upset Yennefer at some point. There's no question. But I can always just justify it by the fact that it's like, she would do the same, and I'm a witcher. Right? Doesn't matter, because that's what I'm doing.
Can't hold on no longer.
Man, I miss this place.
Your kind spreads disease. Defeatism and desertion.
I can't even get sick. Spread disease. Okay. Let's plan a course of action here. So we need to go up to near where the manor is. There's a couple of things along the way that we could do. We also have the herbalist here that we need to go and see, so why don't we do that? That might make the most sense. Yeah, it's Otto Bamber. They sometimes use their superhuman senses to find missing persons. There was a notice that we picked up that's taking us here. Yeah, let's do it. I like when we can do things efficiently and they just happen to fall into place like that. That's probably my favorite saying in Oxenfurt. Slap a noon wraith's tits. Well, you know what? I'm just gonna quickly repair our gear here.
Greetings again. So, you got a job for me, an interesting one.
If you call repairing stuff, yeah, sure.
You're in luck.
And I don't think we've played him in Gwent, so this is a good opportunity to throw down.
Mark my words, you'll be satisfied.
Okay. Thank you. We can't sell these bolts, eh? That's too bad. Wonder how much his glyphs are. They're all the same, probably. Yeah, they look like it. All right, here we go. Oh my god, it's been so long. It's been so long. I've Gwent set to hard. So here goes nothing. Couple of decoys. Should I throw one more in there? Nah, let's go with what we have. Nice. This is a decent first draw. We don't have any decoys though, although we might get some. Let's drop Vesemir. There's a Scorch. Let's drop Deathmold. All right. He's coming out firing. It's interesting how much Gwent feels like habitual. You just come in, you just drop like the cards that you know you want to drop repeatedly. Okay, no decoys yet. Not like he's playing any spies anyway, so. Well, we got Siggy. If he's gonna play all these guys early, this is good news for me. This might be a very nice Scorch opportunity. Oh, but we traded. Oh no, we have the Scorch. Let's do it. Okay, beautiful. Alright, there's our decoy, although it seems like it's probably not going to matter anymore. So we need 15. So let's do the catapult, and we'll throw Triss in. We can always bring the catapult back if we pull the other one. Oh, good one. Doesn't hurt us. It only, the scorch only hits on the front row. Well, should we just go for the dagger here? I guess so. There's no real reason we shouldn't, as far as I can tell. That's fine by me. We have the scorch for this card if we really want to, but it's a bit wasteful at this point. Okay, I see what you got going on there. Is that Saskia? Oh yeah, it says synthesis. Beautiful. Okay. Let's go ahead and scorch this one. Hopefully he's lulled into a false sense of security. Having this torrential rain back here. Oh, very smart. Very smart. Yeah, he's pretty much toast. Beautiful. Well, good game, sir. Good game. Yeah, decent cards. Let's see what cards he gives us here. A vampire, Garcane. Alright, we'll take that, I guess. Okay, off we go. Roach, you watch my back.
Greetings. Is it herbs you seek? Medicines to mute a bashful maid's inhibitions? Or a concoction to raise your own courage for a second go?
That it? No other weeds or brews?
Aye. One to make your hair grow, another to do the opposite. An easer of pain, a calmer of heartburn. Tell me what
is it called, milk? Okay. So we haven't played him either. Let's ask him if he knows any master formulae.
Know any advanced formulae? Maybe something you could teach me?
All I know, I learned from Master Grimmest of Skelliger. Looking to apprentice yourself in the herbalist trade?
Wouldn't hurt.
I just want to learn something new.
Call it what you will. You must sail across the great sea, find the
We've
Isle
talked
of
to Grimmest,
Skellig.
I'm pretty sure.
There, in the sacred grove, the learned Master Grimmest will judge whether
he's the one that put us through all that trouble.
Let me have a look.
Let's see. I know we need Arenaria, so I'm just going to go ahead and grab that. But we need, like, we need a bunch of White Gull, I believe, which I'm going to have to buy somewhere else.
Hear about the contract.
Whew, a taker at long last. Poverty in everyone's lips, but when you've a job to give, no one's eager. Folk are lazy, that's the truth of it.
You're not wrong.
Stick to the point if you don't mind.
Right. Sorry for the chatter. I'm anxious, is all. Been so long without any word. It's my apprentice, Falkert. I sent him to the Dead White Wood. You know, the forest near Martin Foy's farmstead. I'd run out of hand fiber, see, and the damned stuff grows thick as weeds there.
Let me guess. Hasn't returned.
Yes. No, he hasn't. Please, find him and bring him back safe and sound.
Okay.
No promises, but I can certainly look for him. Any distinguishing features? How will I recognize him?
Got to think on that. Well, he's a halfling, as I am. Light hair. Will that do?
It'll have to. So long.
Beautiful. Okay. So, is he nearby? Looks like relatively. So, he's up here. And we need to, isn't that, like, is that the same place that we need to be going? Oh, not quite. Okay. So, that being said, though, we can definitely stop along the way. And we could even take that a few steps further and check out some of these things if we want. Our friends, the Fallen Knights. Where is the Hangman's Venom? I guess that's probably permanently on here, so I don't need to do it. Now, how come we didn't get our Quen there? Because we should have... When you enter combat, there's a 100% chance you'll automatically get a Quen shield without using any stamina. That's not good. Unless it did and I got hit maybe by an arrow or something I didn't catch.
Come on, come closer.
Wow, he really fell. Come on. Come on.
What? Lost your nerve?
These guys with the halberds are insane. Gotta be a little bit more patient. Since we are saving up to buy some very expensive rune tools, we're probably just gonna grab almost everything that we see now. Is this the one that we saw? No, I'm certain we've read this by Dune. Here we go. Pitch camp in the middle, or sorry, pitch camp in the ruins of the observation towers as M ordered. Hope we won't have to sit here long. Margin note, important, Bren lost 200 crowns to me at Gwent, but has no coin on him, need to take it out of his next share of the loot. Boring as fuck. Been sitting here 8 days now and naught's happened, besides that one grain caravan which we raided, sending the merchants off running in only their unspeakables. Hope to high heavens they'll transfer us somewhere more interesting quick, because here every man jack of us is near about off his nut with boredom. Because here every man jack of us is near. What does that mean? Jack of us is near about off his nut with boredom. That's a very weird way to say words. Hello, more Order of the Flaming Rose armor. Might have to start a little collection. Okay, let's check out this town.
Go, go.
That'll do. Nope. Come on. Off. Okay. Give us a little space here. Get our necrophage oil going. Now again, I don't think we got the Quen. So I don't know if that's like a glitch or what that's what's happening, but come on, they're all like burning. We've isolated one, kind of. Come on. You're welcome. Okay, I don't know what this song is that they're singing.
Show me what you've got on offer.
Oh, he's got lots. Nothing that we're gonna buy. Actually, if he's gonna take this stuff, we'll give it to him.
So long.
Now, what is this? Yes, it's a real Witcher, little one. Surprise inheritance. Yeah, we could use this. Let's read his notes. Kulik Kulikov and his men are busy preparing the hunt, so I have a few moments to write up this whole incredible affair. Week back, I arrived home in Oxenford after a long journey and found I'd received a letter from my barrister. My Aunt Helena had finally passed on and left all her belongings, including her hut outside Novigrad, to me. The letter included a copy of her will and a key to the chest in which she had stashed her savings. Remembering how my dear auntie would serve her guests only bread and water, I was sure she'd managed to save up a hefty stash of coin during her long and miserly life. So I raced off in a flash to my aunt's hut to pay my respects at her grave, and while there, take a gander at what's in that chest. But when I got there, the hut was in ruins, and the neighboring peasants were claiming a griffin had nested on my aunt's lands. So there I was, a fortune in arm's reach and not a way to get at it. So I went back to Oxenford and raced to the academy. I raced to the alchemy, fast as my feet would take me, for I'd heard the famous Kulik Kulikov and his crew were watering their horses there after their latest adventure. We agreed terms quick enough, he'd get a portion of what we found in the chest, and set off to determine this plowing pest of a griffin. Set off to exterminate this plowing pest of a griffin. Now I'm sitting and watching Kulikov's lads arm the ballista, writing this all down to calm my nerves and pass the time. Fun's about to start. Well, there's the ballista. I don't see a griffin, so maybe they did get it. Nope. Nope, they didn't. Let's just be ready for this. Keep a close eye on our Quen. And you know what? Let's put the blade oil on as well. These ones are hybrids, right? Yeah. Let's go for the hybrid oil. And let's throw on our echidna decoction. Thunderbolt never hurt. 39. And no... Oh, no, we do have Quen. Okay, that's good. I almost wonder if we had it and I just didn't notice it before. I wonder if we can use... Where's our bomb? The northern wind. I'll try and take him out. Or get him down first. Not quite as well as it works on others.
Die.
Got him. Okay, if we get killed falling down here. I have a feeling that there's not going to be a ton of riches. That's just the cynical witcher in me coming out. Yeah. Okay. So, not quite the riches we were hoping for. 13 florins. And then superior hybrid oil. Which is fine, I'll take that. Let's see if that's something that we can actually craft. superior hybrid. Nope. We're short some albedo and bison grass. We can make albedo, but we cannot, in fact, make bison grass. Okay, where are we? So we have to head north. Let's go ahead and head up to this one. That was actually kind of cool. I like that you could see the ballista, like, trying to attack it, or at least the positioning. Kind of tells the whole story there, but obviously things didn't work out for them, but that is to my advantage. Gotta say, roaches drastically improved in our time apart. As with every relationship, sometimes that's a good thing. Force or not.
You just died.
Whoa. Die. So do we have Quen up right now? Brothers. You know what I wonder? I wonder if it's not triggering because we're on the horse. Because that one definitely didn't happen. Damn it. Roach, this is not really the best time.
I live, I die, I live again.
Okay. I don't know what he was doing in there.
How long you gonna make me wait?
Jesus. Finish him. There we go.
Come on, come closer.
That was pretty gnarly.
Come on.
Whew. Boot diagram. Hello. Order of the Flame Rose armor. This is untranslated, of course. A crumpled letter. Let's see the crumpled letter. Or is that part of this? Nope. So that's part of the gear that we needed to find. Tour, Ulrich told me to send you one of these stolen diagrams. He's dead set on puzzling them out quick as possible. No idea what's put the fire to his breeches, but knowing him, there's coin involved, sure as shaving. So if you do manage to decipher anything, write me first and we'll reconnoiter on what to do next. That lout's starting to rile me. Sits on his arse all the time, getting up only to come chew us out. High time he was taught a lesson. Yep, a little overthrow happening, I think. Come on, Roach, it's okay. Okay, let's head over to this one. I didn't think you'd like this hill. Oh my god. Of course, after I give you some praise. Hold on. I think we might be dealing with a wyvern here. Okay, let's grab some draconid oil. Yeah, see, there it goes. So I think it has to do with... if we're on Roach or not, which is kind of disappointing, but... come on, you beast. Come on back. He's gonna die. He's just gonna bleed out. Fighting these things, these Dragon big beasts,
need to destroy it.
Does not get old. Level 37. Wow. Lesser glyph, monster hearts, dragon scales. Beautiful stuff. Okay. Got one more location right near. We'll grab the other two that are pretty linear along the way, on the way back. Assuming we have to go back through Oxford. We do, actually, because of the auction house. Roach, meet me at the bottom.
Come on, Roach.
Another one. That's convenient.
Lost your nerve.
Oh god. Oh. Not sure how to handle this. Whoa! Roach, calm down. This place.
Draconid nest. Need to destroy it.
There's another one? I think we might just let the other one survive.
Go, go.
Okay, let's go see Shiny. Whoa.
Hey-ya.